Hyderabad House for the press statement of Prime Minister Narendra Modi and visiting Myanmar President U Thin Khon. This is the first visit by a Myanmarese head of state to India after the new government took over power. A very significant visit, in fact, and expected to boost traditionally close ties between the two countries. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj there entering the room where the press conference will take place. It's the first high-level visit after the civilian government took over office in Myanmar. Earlier, the visiting Myanmar president was given a ceremonial reception.
Excellency U Thin Chow, President of the Republic of the Union of Myanmar, Honorable Prime Minister, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to today's ceremony where four MOUs will be exchanged. The first MOU is cooperation in the construction of 69 bridges, including approach roads in the Tamu Chiogon Kalewa road section of the Trilateral Highway in Myanmar. This will be exchanged on the Myanmar side by U Chiao Lin, Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Construction, and on the Indian side by Foreign Secretary Dr. S. Jaishankar. Excellencies, the second MOU is on cooperation in the construction and upgradation of the Kalewa-Yagi road section. This will be exchanged on the Myanmar side by U Chiao Lin, Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Construction, and on the Indian side by Foreign Secretary Dr. S. Jaishankar. MOU number three is cooperation in the field of renewable energy. This will be exchanged on the Myanmar side by Excellency U Chiao Thin, Minister of State for Foreign Affairs, and on the Indian side by Shri Upendra Tripathi, Secretary, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. The fourth MOU is on cooperation in the field of traditional systems of medicine, exchanged on the Myanmar side by Excellency U Chiao Thin, Minister of State for Foreign Affairs, and on the Indian side by Shri Ajit M. Saran, Secretary, Ministry of Ayush. Excellencies, this concludes the exchange of agreements ceremony. I now hand over to our spokesperson.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We will now have press statements by the two leaders. May I first invite the Prime Minister of India to deliver his statement.
Your Excellency, President U Thin Chow, members of the media, I am delighted to welcome His Excellency U Thin Chow, President of Myanmar, and his distinguished delegation to India. Excellency, we are deeply honored that you have chosen India for your first bilateral state visit abroad. Friends, Myanmar is special for us. It holds a unique position in India's neighborhood. It is a land bridge that connects India with South Asia. The long-standing cultural and historical linkages between our two societies form a solid foundation of our ties. Buddhist principles of metta, or loving kindness, and sarva panth sambhav, equality of all religions, define our ways of life. Excellency, your great nation has entered a new era, an era defined by maturity of your leadership and commitment of your people to democracy, and which is accompanied by clear vision and a strong desire of your leadership to make Myanmar a stable and economically prosperous country in the region. As the new government of Myanmar starts its journey to grow its agriculture, develop its industry and infrastructure, strengthen its education, skill its youth, build new institutions and strengthen existing ones, secure its society, seek a firm path to economic prosperity, and above all, pursue an ambition to build a modern nation. Let me assure you that at every step of the way, 1.25 billion people of India will stand by you, both as partners and as friends. Friends, President and I have just concluded useful discussions on the whole range of our bilateral engagement. We recognize that our security interests are closely aligned, and we agreed on the need to remain sensitive to each other's strategic interests and concerns. To this end, President and I agreed to work together for the safety and security of our people and actively cooperate to combat the common challenges of terrorism and insurgent activity in our region. I have also conveyed India's full support to the peace process initiative under the 21st century Panglong Conference. Friends, India-Myanmar partnership is defined not just by good words and pure intent. Its extent and depth is shaped by robust development cooperation partnership which has strong people-first philosophy. India's nearly $1.75 billion development assistance is touching the lives of the common man of Myanmar. Our engagement is supporting projects in connectivity, infrastructure, capacity building, education, healthcare, and many other sectors. Some concrete examples of our partnership include Kaladan project, which is port and waterway segment in near completion later this year, India-Myanmar-Thailand trilateral highway, Myanmar Institute of Information Technology, advanced center of agriculture research and education as well as smaller projects in health, education and industrial training sectors. The two operational agreements signed today will facilitate the construction and upgrading of 69 bridges and the Kalewa-Yargi road section of the trilateral highway project. We are also determined to deepen our cooperation in agriculture, banking, power and energy. The MOUs on cooperation in renewable energy and on traditional systems of medicine will operationalize our cooperation in these areas. We have also agreed to work towards a long-term and mutually beneficial arrangements for trade in pulses. In April this year, we took the small step of supplying power to Tamu in Myanmar. I have also told the President that we are willing to substantially scale up our supply of power. Excellency, India stands ready to enhance our development partnership with Myanmar and do so as per the priorities of the Myanmar government. Friends, culture is a cornerstone of the foundation of our countries, our ties. I'm happy that our partnership is restoring Ananda Temple in Bagan in Myanmar. We are also ready to restore other historic monuments and pagodas which were damaged in the earthquake which hit Myanmar just last week. Excellency, your visit has been most timely, and our discussions today have enabled us to evolve our roadmap and an action agenda for our cooperation. I look forward to working with you to take the relationship to new heights. A bright future for Myanmar is not just your objective, it is also our aspiration. Once again, Excellency, a very warm welcome to India. Thank you. Thank you very much.
May I now invite His Excellency U Thin Chaw, the President of Myanmar, to deliver his address.
Your Excellency, Prime Minister Narendra Modi of the Republic of India, distinguished guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen. I came to visit India at the invitation of His Excellency President Sri Pranab Mukherjee. I'm glad to witness development of India and to visit places of religious and historic significance in India, especially Bodh Gaya and Agra. I am pleased to note that there has been increased exchange of high-level visits between our two countries, especially after our new government assumed office in March 2016. My current visit to India is aimed at enhancing the traditional ties of friendship between our two governments and peoples, as well as strengthening the cordial relations between our two countries. Earlier today, I held a wide-ranging discussions with His Excellency Sri Narendra Modi, Prime Minister of India, on bilateral, regional, and international issues of mutual interest. Both sides agreed that greater bilateral cooperation between India and Myanmar is required to promote inclusive growth and development and to contribute to peace, stability, prosperity in both countries and in the region as a whole. Both sides also agreed to enhance our cooperation to bring about overall socio-economic development of our two peoples. We are pleased with increasing cultural and academic exchanges between our two countries, and this kind of exchanges should be further strengthened. I'm very pleased with the signing of 4 memoranda of understanding during my present visit. We thank the government of India for their support to our ongoing reform process and efforts towards achieving peace and national reconciliation. Our two countries have been cooperating within regional and multilateral frameworks such as the East Asia Summit, the BIMSTEC, PCEM, Economic Corridor, and the United Nations. Once again, it has been a great pleasure for me to visit India at this juncture and exchange views with leaders of India to further develop our bilateral relations and cooperation in regional and international contexts. Thank you, Excellency.
I thank the two leaders for their statements. This concludes the joint press briefing. Thank you all.